brambly hedge runs along the edge of a cornfield. There's a hornbeam tree, several crabapple trees, a large stump overgrown with moss and ivy, some elderberry bushes, a splendid oak, and a clump of hawthorn. Brambles and honeysuckle, foxgloves, ferns, and wild roses grow alongside in a tangle of leaves and stems. The mice have their houses in the roots and trunks of the trees. And if you look very hard next time you're out walking in the country, you may be lucky enough to catch a glimpse of a small window or through an open door, a steep flight of stairs. If you do, you'll know that you have found Brambly Hedge.
It's a beautiful day. You should have come with me, Primrose.
There have been mice living in Brambly Hedge for many generations. This is Old Oak Palace, where Lord Woodmouse, the head of the community, lives with his wife, Lady Daisy, and their daughter, Primrose.
Guess what? It's Wilfred's birthday!
Oh, I know. That's exactly why I've come.
Now, would you like some porridge, Mr. Apple?
No, thank you, Mrs. Crusty Bread.
Lord Woodmouse knows all about the customs and traditions in Brambly Hedge, so the other mice always ask him when they want to know the best way to do things.
I'll help you light them.
My.
Because he knows so much about the hedge, he's even writing a book about it. Lady Daisy, his wife, has painted all the pictures of Brambly Hedge and the mice who live there. She has also painted lots of pictures for Mrs. Apple's recipe book. The palace is in the largest, oldest tree in the hedge, and although it may look like an ordinary tree from the outside, the trunk has been hollowed out to form a beautiful and grand home with many, many rooms. At its center is an enormous ballroom, and it is here that many of the great Brambly Hedge parties are held. And for the mice, celebrations always involve food.
Supper is served. Come along, everybody.
Oh, wow, this is wonderful.
What a feast.
All the mice of Brambly Hedge keep their food here in the store stump. Mr. Apple is in charge of the dozens of storerooms, larders, cellars, and drying rooms. From spring to autumn, the mice gather different sorts of food, such as fruit, berries, and nuts, and deliver them to Mr. Apple. It is his job to make sure that everything is safely stored away for the hard months of winter.
There's just the right amount of space for this last basket.
That's splendid, my dear. I'm so glad we sorted it out.
The mice will always need the store stump's supplies when there's snow on the ground and their own cupboards are empty.
Good morning, everyone.
As well as shelves and cupboards, the store stump has an enormous kitchen where the mice make jams and syrups on a grand scale, and where they roast crabapples and wild cherries. Mushrooms and herbs are hung from the rafters to dry, so that in winter they can be soaked and used in soups and nut stews. In spring and summer, the mice collect herbs from the hedge and seeds and mushrooms from the fields. In autumn, the mice set off for the bramble patch to pick blackberries. They need to bring the harvest into the store stump before the rain comes to spoil it.
I'll get it.
Wilfred?
It's the biggest berry yet.
Picking blackberries is hard work, but the mice enjoy it. Led by Lord Woodmouse, they help each other to harvest all the ripe berries, filling their baskets quickly and carefully. The grown-ups keep an eye on the weather, while the young mice have great fun helping to pick berries, and eating a few too. At the end of their day's work, the mice are happy to know that they have added to their winter food store. Mr. Apple won't mind having the problem of finding space for it all in the store stump. The little mice have to learn what is good to eat and what is not. Before they pick anything from the hedge, they must ask a grown-up if it is safe to do so, because the brightest berries can sometimes be the most dangerous. They know they must never, ever touch the fruits of the deadly nightshade plants that grow at the edge of the far woods, because they are very, very poisonous. All along the hedge, there are delicious smells as the mice prepare jams, jellies, and preserves for Mr. Apple's safekeeping. Close by, in Crabapple Cottage, live Mr. and Mrs. Apple.
That smells good.
They're gone. Wait, they're gone. Wait, they're gone. Wait.
I have the feeling that young Wilfred can't wait.
Mrs. Apple is an excellent cook. And at the end of a long day, Mr. Apple likes nothing better than to sit down with her by the fire and have his supper on a tray.
Well, I wouldn't set my heart on blackberry sorbet or a snowball if I were you.
Oh.
Snow would have to come all the way up to the third notch from the old oak palace. Can't think of all that cold snow when I'm sitting by our warm fire, eating the best mushroom pie in Bramley Hedge.
Oh.
Next door to Crabapple Cottage is the hornbeam tree, where the Toadflax family live.
Wake up! Wake up! Wake up! Wake up!
Mr. and Mrs. Toadflax have their paws full with their four lively children, Catkin and Clover, Wilfred and Teasel.
And I'll knock it over.
Hey, be careful.
Mum, guess what? We're snowed in.
Wilfred said he's going to dig us out.
Oh, he does he? Well, you just go and remind him that young mice never dig without the help of a grown-up. I'll go and get your father up.
While Mrs. Toadflax is scurrying around looking after the children, Mr. Toadflax prefers to take things easy. Mice can find everything they need in the area around Bramley Hedge.
Not exactly full, Mrs. Eyebright, but very close. Mrs. Apple and I are just trying to find space for today's gathering.
Good morning, Mrs. Eyebright. If you find a place for this deer, then we'll have room for that.
We think there could be a problem.
The trees provide housing. The earth gives food. And wind and water supply power for the mill and the dairy. Down by the stream is the dairy stump. Some friendly cows give milk to the mice each day, and Poppy Eyebright looks after the making and storing of butters and cheeses for the hedge. She makes hard cheeses and soft cheeses. Curd cheeses, spiced cheeses, smoked cheeses, herb butters, and thick clotted cream. The nearby flour mill has a big water wheel, which is turned by the fast-moving river. As the big wooden mill wheel slowly turns, it starts the machinery that moves the great millstones round and round. Dusty Dogwood, the miller, grinds roots, nuts, acorns, sweet chestnuts, and beech, and dried red clover, as well as corn and grass seeds, into flour, which he then bags and stores in the roots of the mill. Whenever there is a celebration, be it a wedding or a birthday, the midwinter ball or a baby mouse's naming day, Basil Brightberry is always called upon to bring wines and cordials for the feast. He lives at Elderberry Lodge, but keeps his bottles in a dark cellar in the store stump.
Elderberry cordial, an essential ingredient.
Hawthorne Rise is where old Mrs. Eyebright, Poppy's grandmother, lives. Her eyesight is not as good as it was, but she still takes an active part in the life of the hedge. Lord Woodmouse often asks her how things were done long ago, when he wants to get the details in his book just right.
Isn't that right, Mrs. Eyebright?
Like many elderly mice, Mrs. Eyebright can usually tell when the weather's going to change, and she can warn of storms or heavy snowfall.
Smells like a
She is almost always right, too.
There's a feeling in the air, just like that time long, long ago when the snow got so deep, it went all the way to the top of the third notch on the old oak palace.
Wow!
What is it?
I smell a storm. Could be a big one. Still a fair way off, but we'd better warn all the mice who are out harvesting. They'll have to move a little quicker than they thought to get everything in before the rain.
Life in Brambley Hedge goes on as it always has done. Whatever the weather and whatever the season, the mice are constantly busy. They all have their own special jobs to help everything run smoothly.
Mind your backs now. Make way.
We have everything here but the punch, dear.
In spite of all the hard work that has to be done, there is always time for play, for feasts and celebrations, surprise picnics, or just the delight of a lazy, sunny afternoon.
Good night, Flax. Good night, Lily.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Sleep tight.
When the sun goes down, the sleepy mice make their way home, draw their curtains and get ready for bed. Happy with each other and happy with their lives in Brambley Hedge.
Ease your whiskers, rest your paws. Pies and puddings fill the stores. Sweetly dream the night away till sunshine brings another day.
So remember, if you do come across Brambley Hedge when you're out walking, don't tell anyone where it is, will you? The mice are very shy and would not want to be disturbed.